Recently, my son and I, we were talking about the book of Revelation and drew some comparisons to the movie Mad Max The Road Warrior, starring Mel Gibson. We believe Mel Gibson would have preferred that movie would have some kind of biblical tie-ins. We also felt there was an entire story missing between the first and second movie. So my son started playing with his concept and came up with a completed script. The following is his version of how Mad Max survived the nuclear war. The Revelations is a book of prophecies and of future events. Revelation chapter 6 verses 3 to 4. When the Lamb opened the second seal, I heard the second living creature say, "Come." Then another horse came out, a fiery red one. Its rider was given power to take peace from the earth and to make men slay each other. To him was given a large sword. It is believed this passage of scripture refers to a nuclear war. Behind this chaos are specifically selected targets to quickly reduce the world's population and cripple the people's strength so that they are submissive to control.
Within a land where the lawless own the roads and the sins of demons are allowed to run rampant and free, one warrior stands against the fires of wickedness, a man by the name of Max. Once a man who stood by the laws of truth and justice, the corruption of the earth found its way into the very heart of Max's being. At the height of his life, Max had a wife and child, but with one collision, his family and all other light in his existence was ripped from him. Flames of Max's grief came an unstoppable vengeance. As Max's life grew darker, so did the world around him. It was there, in the scrap of the dreaded machines which took his life, that the Road Warrior was born.
Get all the food and gasoline they can ever find!
There may not be a whole lot left in this little tiny church, but we're all sons of God. We do not need to be hostile. Listen, if you did get any guzzling, there'll just be enough to get you in this little armpit of a town. Not very much at all. Look, whatever you do, don't set this church ablaze.
We ain't much for sharing, Pastor, but all we want is your food and guzzling for the Red Rider. Now, the Red Rider is on his way, and we want to make sure that you pay your dues.
Hey, what has gotten into you guys? Listen, you don't need to burn down this church. You don't need to ransack people's homes and steal. All you need is salvation. Come on, get your heads on straight. Now listen, if you help me, I will help you. I'll help you in more ways than you know. Not only will I show you the path to God, I can also show you where you can find all the guzzling you could ever need. It's in a little town not far from here. But you have to take me with you. Gotta leave this church alone!
You think we're stupid? We don't believe you! You lie, religious guy! And we don't believe that such a huge amount of guzzling even exists. We would have found it already.
Get in now!
Look, friend, I can't possibly leave now. God's holy temple is in trouble. It needs me now more than ever.
Stay here any longer, I'm going to kill you.
Whoa.
Hey, thank you for saving my life. My name is Pastor George, by the way. Hey, that was my church back there. Yeah, it was my church. It's burning.
All I need to know is if you can direct us to that fuel stash we were talking about back there.
Whoa! Do you know what you're doing? Whoa! This is really intense!
The nuclear blast too. Oh, come on!
But what?
Yeah. Oh no!
Those guys are behind us. Look out!
Thank you.
clear now.
No, you don't understand. If we don't get to that tunnel in the next few minutes, we're all gonna be dead.
What are you talking about?
Just trust me. When I say a nuclear bomb is about to fall, we need to get to that tunnel right now.
Hang on!
Oh, they're gaining on us!
Pull your seat back all the way.
Why?
Just do it!
You got him!
The nuke.
Hey, do you remember during the disappearance when all those people were taken?
Yeah, it's still a mystery.
Yeah, well, for the last several weeks, I've been receiving visions from God, warnings about the nuclear blast. I tried to warn people in the community about it, but nobody would listen to me. They called me a liar the entire time. Many claimed that I had lost my mind.
Are you trying to tell me that the disappearance and the nuclear blast have something to do with each other?
Yes, but you see, to the Christians, the disappearance is known by another name, the rapture. It's an event prophesied what will happen in the end times. A time when Jesus will return, call upon the Christians to return with him to heaven.
The people that were taken in the disappearance, they were Christian, weren't they?
Exactly! Ever since I've been preaching, only to those who have either closed off their hearts from God or are too scared to believe in the truth.
What about you? If all Christians were taken up to heaven, why are you still here?
Everyone has a fair chance of salvation. You just have to choose God. You have to believe it in your heart, not just in knowledge and wisdom. We're not judged by that. We're judged by our heart.
This nuclear blast will only increase the madness of those who are still left anymore. We're going to have to ration our food out because of the radiation. Looks like we're going to be stuck down here for a while.
You're right. We've got to get to work. But before we do, I need to know one thing. What is your name?
I'm Max.
Well, thank you, Max, for saving my life.
My skills as an old mechanic kept Max and I busy in the guts of the earth. We took his car apart and rebuilt it countless of times until he ended up with the know-how to repair it or build a new one from scratch. Finally, after adding a few minor adjustments,
including a self-destruct bomb and a harpoon. We had his car loaded with booby traps. Mainly, we lived off dinky-doo dog food. There's crates of the stuff. We spent months down in those tunnels, going super deep. We explored every possible place there could be. We ran into a lot of shady people.
Stuff? You can't have it. Just this bullet. Nothing survived.
Before you ask, I drew some instructions on the back of my Bible.
where to find that guzzling stash. I promise. There's no traps waiting for you there. Oh.
But the nuclear blast. The stash should be gone, right?
I knew there was gonna be a nuclear blast. I told you that. But I tried to hide the guzzling where it wouldn't be hit. It's deep underground. Not accessible from right here. But others are gonna look to you for help.
How will I be able to help anyone out here in this mess?
Rip.
And what's the second thing?
With a supply stash that I have set aside for you, you'll have all you need. So you can reach where you'll be needed. You may not think of yourself as a hero, Max. But I've foreseen you out there on the road. I wanted to help those people, but I can't, obviously. My time is up. But through you, I can help you, and in turn, you can help them. There's another thing I need to tell you, Max. There's near the guzzling, and I placed a guard dog. I want you to take him in. Be good to him. He'll be faithful to you. He's always been a loyal dog.
I'll be lucky enough to survive on my own.
Here, Max, I tore this fabric from the Red Rider's cloak. Use it as a bandana around your arm to remember me by. Oh yeah, and one more thing. Thanks!
It took the road warrior a full day before he found Pastor George's supply stash. Everything that was promised was there. With a full tank and the open road lying before him, Max began his quest for the Plains of Silence, where peace and serenity could be his at long last. Just as Pastor George had predicted, Max ended up leading many to find peace of their own. The road warrior achieved many feats of greatness. Each time he found it easier to reconnect with his humanity. By the end of the road warrior's life, Max found God just as Pastor George had. Through all those years, Max kept George's Bible, and once he began to study it, Max was able to learn the truth that so many were too blind to realize. The truth that George had promised him before his passing. There's only one way to reach the plains which Max sought. Through prayer and a loving trust in Jesus Christ, Max was able to ascend to heaven. Where there had once been hate, there was now love, and anger was now swapped out for calm serenity. Max reached the potential that all of humanity can. If the road warrior could find the love of Jesus Christ, then perhaps the rest of us children of God can too.
What is wrong with you?
You look like crying.
Who talks like that?
Look.
Oh, looks like you're dead. You're dead. Okay, one more time. Okay. No, wait,
not
I was
yet.
Right.
Not yet.
One more time. Okay. Switch.
Switch. We can catch it in the most.
I got it recording.
Do you see my face?
Yeah.
And then just point it out this way, and I'll just do this.
Okay. Jeff.
Yeah, just stretch your arm out across my side, and then shoot it.
Oh, sorry. My ears are ringing.
Then he says, "I'm Max. I'm Max."
How am I supposed to? This line is this. So I guess I'll look at the camera for this one?
I would do that.
No.
Come on. Tell me.
I'm Max.
I'm Max.
Okay.
I'm Max.
Put your hand on the thing, and then look at the camera slowly. Come on, you can do it. You know what it's gonna look like. That's why you're laughing. Now come on, just do it again. Put your hand on there. Turn your head. You were just about to do it. Almost a delivery. Come on.
The more serious I take it, the funnier
it's
it is.
So easy. Okay.
What do I say?
Oh, trouble. We aren't allowed to. Trouble. We aren't alone. trouble. We aren't alone down here anymore. Quick, get in the car.
Okay. Uh-oh, trouble. We're not alone down here. Quick, get in the car.
Okay.
You're gonna have to cut it real close now, cause this is okay. Go out there, your boss. Okay.
Okay.
I'll drive that tanker.
It's a risk we'll have to take. We either get buried alive down here.
Here, let's see.